chimwacho anga chino chigena kuto samu musibu na inga chimwacho tachinantu samu bizi akatwe kano. The Right Honourable Speaker of Parliament on Wednesday, which happened to be yesterday, on the floor of Parliament, yale seyo echiteso cha Parliament. That's what they got to do, right? Bage na neva tutesesa. They legislate. And her contribution to the floor yesterday was Eddie Kenzo is in dire straits, stuck in Cote d'Ivoire. And she is appealing to the minister of, or the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the president, who is also going to apparently find out about this, to help repatriate and bring Eddie Kenzo back home because he is not doing well, given sentences on na ya zikozesa. And so she's calling out to have either our people there who have a mission to reach out to him and, you know, send him or pay his flight bills. And I'm like, Natula no nembabuza, Eddie Kenzo siya, so say Eddie Kenzo siya mna Uganda yeka, Kwame Day in another country when a global pandemic happened. I have personal friends who are actually stuck as, they're stuck in South Africa, they're stuck in Norway, they're stuck in very weird, complex places with so little to go by. But they are just waiting their days as they make do. And there's not a country that doesn't understand why you're stuck here. There's humanity is alive and well, people. We are not all just, you know, ragheads. People will help. They understand. So I believe with the way that the world is starting to open up, Eddie Kenzo should not be a conversation on the floor of Parliament. I don't care who is going to sit out there and say, Njoge Debubi. Then the Artists Association also comes out, Jesus. Abayimbi bafe, neba comedians, neba actors, bacha akola what they do best, bacha sabiriza. Oh, mbogoba ni COVID. Yaba isiza bubi nyonyonyonyonyo, tebama nyichakola. So, they are asking the Ministry of Gender and Labour to put aside small monies to help them boost online simanya viewership, simanya online payments so that they can also... Abayimbi be Uganda, it's Thursday! Throwbacks. I saw the commentary on I think it was YouTube and on Facebook, and your guys were commenting about the throwbacks and that it's a Friday, how I'm no longer giving that. Actually, someone made it a topic on Twitter that I just left you guys for. I don't throw back anymore. I don't scream it's a Friday. Well, I have myself. Let me explain this. I don't want to throw back during these unprecedented times because I don't want nostalgia to hit me in ways that make me miss the good old times, because then it will make it harder for me to just get by during these times. I hope there's someone out there who hears me preaching and says, amen, sister. And as for it's a Friday, I mean, do you know the thing we always say, it's 5 o'clock somewhere? Well, even with COVID-19, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. I may be celebrating it's a Friday down in Uganda, and in Brazil, so I just find that a little bit insensitive to begin celebrating that much. I'm celebrating the little successes. I'm just like every one of you, if Friday's show comes up, sit in your living room and help me do the screaming. It's a Friday, but I... My name is Tina Fierce One, and of course the show is proudly sponsored by Metropolitan University. For now, welcome. Mr. Mondo, Pastor Mondo, stood, no he didn't stand, he sat up there in his red Teletubby outfit and literally told everybody that the only rich people are fat, in ways to say, okay, this is how he put it. I was trying to understand it, but for me, this is how it made sense to me. He said, Teri bagagabo sanga nezi sixi paka. Teri bagagabo sanga muzi gym, kubaku macha chwe, 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 chwe. Nagamba motevali yoteri mugagda gugenda sanganga li ripped ngaina masonga ina bichi. Bonna babiri nabavu bali ali mutaka mumpaka balinze takisi boda beba naku. Bayasasa nayogera. Kind of made sense. Ladies and gentlemen, I am a female in Kampala. Whenever you meet a ripped guy in Kampala, angalina zino. Manya m***. Zaina was a gula creatine. Nagenda ku gym. But then here's where I disagreed. For a man who considers himself a pastor, it means he is thorough when it comes to theology, which means he understands certain things in ways that we don't understand them. Part of theology is actually psychology too. How do you sit there looking as big as you are and trying to make an excuse for how you are? So was Mondo trying to tell us that because he is, I'm not going to be sad with it. It's something that we have to talk about. It's health. Mondo is not slightly obese. He is obese. That is not a good lifestyle I saw there. That was no, Mondo, no. I mean, I get it. The broke men are the ones in gym, but you, what is your excuse? My Jesus, he looked like he had eaten two other men. And they were talking on behalf of Jesus. Africa, what is wrong with us? Why do we get ideologies we cannot explain so well and try to put them out there? This man, I was watching the clip and I was like, hey, if Sanity was a person, this guy right here. And he knows he's dying in his own feeling.
Look at boys who spend their time in a gym. Ngabetika. I've never seen a man who is a kanyama. No, six pack for who, God's sake? Let me tell you how it is. I've never seen a man with six pack who has billion, who's a billionaire. He's not there. Baba kumaba billionaire. So the very kanyama, there is no kanyama who is a billionaire. They are all broke. They are all walking on the border. They are using a taxi. You find them in the taxi park when like, hey, but never have. I'm against going to get into much food. They are all brain is in the chest. So going back, I don't think it's right to look for a man who spends his 8 day hours in gym lifting